राइट्स ऑफ अनपेड सेलर, सेल ऑफ गुड्स एक्ट 1930, अनपेड सेलर एंड हिज राइट्स। हु इज़ अनपेड सेलर? ही इज़ द सेलर टू होम होल ऑफ द प्राइसेस इज नॉट पेड एंड सेकेंड इज कंडीशनल पेमेंट। बिल ऑफ एक्सचेंज, प्रॉमिसरी नोट, चेक हैज़ बीन रिसीव्ड बाय सेलर बट इट डिसऑनर्स टिल द टाइम बिल ऑफ एक्सचेंज प्रॉमिसरी नोट चेक इज विद द सेलर सो टिल दैट टाइम ही इज़ ओनली कॉल्ड अ सेलर बट वेन एनी ऑफ द मैंशनड इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स डिसऑनर देन आफ्टर दिस सेलर इज कॉल्ड अनपेड सेलर। फीचर्स ऑफ एन अनपेड सेलर, सेलर मस्ट सेल गुड्स ऑन कैश बेसिस एंड मस्ट बी अनपेड इन कैश ट्रांजेक्शन, पेमेंट्स बिकम्स ड्यू इंस्टेंटली। सेलर मस्ट बी अनपेड ईदर होल्ली और पार्टली। टू डिसाइड पीरियड हैज़ एक्सपायर्ड एंड प्राइज हैज़ नॉट बीन पेड टू सेलर, सेलर मस्ट नॉट रिफ्यूज टू एक्सेप्ट द पेमेंट वेयर द प्राइस पेड थ्रू नेगोशिएबल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स बिल ऑफ एक्सचेंज प्रॉमिसरी नोट चेक एंड द सेम हैज़ बीन डिसऑनर्ड। एग्जाम्पल, अ सेल हिज बाइक्स टू बी फॉर रुपीज 60,000 एंड रिसीव्स अ चेक फॉर द प्राइस। टिल दिस टाइम सेलर विल ओनली बी कॉल्ड अ सेलर बट वेन सब्सिक्वेंटली a check is dishonored due to insufficiency of funds in B's bank, then only A becomes an unpaid seller. Rights remedies of unpaid seller. The unpaid seller has the rights remedies against goods and buyer both. Rights of unpaid seller against goods. Rights of possession / lien. Rights of stoppage of goods in transit. Third, right of resale. Rights of unpaid seller against buyer. Suit for price, suit for interest and special damages, suit for damage and non-acceptance. Suit for breach of contract. Rights of unpaid seller, goods against goods. Rights of possession / lien. If the buyer fails to pay the price within the decided time, then the unpaid seller has right to keep the goods in his possession and he can refuse to deliver the goods until due payment is paid, when rights of possession can be exercised. When goods are sold on cash basis but payment is unpaid. When goods have been sold on credit basis and the term credit has expired. When the buyer becomes insolvent even within the decided period for payment. So far as the goods are in the possession of unpaid seller, he can exercise this right if goods are lost. Given up, then right of possession lien is also lost, given up. Termination of rights of possession by delivery of goods to the buyer / his agents, by delivery of the to the carrier / courier company, by waiver. This means that if it's specifically mentioned in the contract that seller can't retain the possession of goods even if the price has not been unpaid. When buyer has obtained the possession of goods lawfully. Rights of stoppage of goods in transit. If buyer fails to pay the price within the decided time, then unpaid seller has the right to stop goods in transit. Condition of stoppage of goods. When seller is unpaid either wholly or partially, when the buyer becomes insolvent, goods must be in course of transit. This means that goods must not be in the possession of the seller and have not reached the buyer's possession as well. Termination of transit by delivery to the buyer, his agents. Interception by the buyer. Interception means the act of catching. When buyer or his agent obtains the delivery of the goods before their arrival at the appointed destination, hence the transit comes to an end. Acknowledgement to the buyer by carrier, courier company that they are holding the goods on buyer's behalf. Then also transit comes to an end. Part of delivery of goods. If the part of goods are delivered to the buyer, then the transit comes to an end for the remainder of goods as well. Rights of resale. The unpaid seller has the right to resale the goods. Condition of resale. When the goods are perishable nature, then unpaid seller can resell them immediately without the notice to the buyer. But in case of non-perishable items, unpaid seller needs to send notice to the buyer for selling them. Where unpaid seller gives the notice to the buyer and buyer still don't pay for it. Where the rights of resale is reserved mentioned in the contract, if contract clearly specifies that reselling can't be done or vice versa, buyer becomes insolvent, buyer fails to pay the price of the goods. Rights of unpaid seller against buyer. Suit for price, suit for interest and special damages. Here suit can be filed in for interest and special damages where the interest will be paid on the amount of the deal between seller and buyer of the choice discretion of the court. Suit for damages for non-acceptance. Suit can be filed against the buyer if the buyer wrongly refuses to accept the goods. Suit for breach of contract. Rights, remedies of buyers against sellers. Suit for damages for non-delivery. Suits for interest and special damages. Suit for specific performance. Suit for breach of contract.